Kristen Chenoweth may only be 4'11", but she seems really much taller when she stands on top of her Tony and Emmy Awards. She's also standing tall in the face of criticism from her fellow Christians for her public support of gay rights. Her new album is Some Lessons Learned. So please welcome everybody, Kristen Chenoweth.
Thank you, guys.
You're very popular here.
I slept with all of them.
Did you really? Yes, I've heard that about you. So
I'm a wild lady.
Now, this album is a country album, yep. Which is new for you, right?
Well, you know, people don't know me as a country artist, and I am new to the genre, but that's how I grew up singing.
So oh, you did?
I finally got to do the one I've done a lot. Ones I want to do, the Christian record, the Christmas record. The first one was 30s and 40s big band orchestral.
Oh.
And I love that. But
yeah.
This is getting back to my roots not these.
Where did you grow up?
Oklahoma.
Oklahoma. Oh, mm-hmm. I guess that's country music territory.
Totally.
Big time, right?
Yeah, totally, totally.
Okay, so we have a clip of you performing a song
from
the album. So let's watch that. Look at you, you sexy little thing, you, lying there all sexy like that.
It takes a village.
I'm telling you. And what's this song about, what's this song I want somebody bitch about? What does that mean, bitch about?
I want somebody I can bitch about.
Oh, that I can bitch about.
I mean, don't you?
Yes.
That's why you got married.
Well, I have someone now, yeah. But you have another song, What Would Dolly Do?
Yeah.
Also, it says, What Would Dolly Do? -WWDD. I'm assuming that Dolly's boobs inspired this. Dolly Parton's boobs, right?
Yes, because she is my favorite singer, and I don't know how she feels about it, but I kind of approached the record, this album, What Would She Do? Because, you know, I was born, but not yesterday. I'm not a spring chicken, and I've lived a little bit more than some of the younger country artists, and But I also had a lot to say, and I thought, how would she handle heartbreak? What would Dolly do? And then I was like, why am I not writing that song, WWDD? So I did.
I see. You could play her, you know, at some point. But
thank you.
You'd have to get gigantic input.
There would be a couple things I'm missing, and I could take care of that.
But you'd tip over. I mean, it would be scary. Somebody told me you have some sort of illness that causes vertigo.
I'm so glad you're bringing this up. I want to bring more information and knowledge about this disease. It's called Meniere's disease.
Oh, Meniere's, yes.
Yeah, you've heard of it.
Well, I've had Meniere with filet of sole. I know that. Filet of sole a la Meniere. You never had that? Sorry,
but I'm going to go tonight and have it. But it's an inner ear infection that causes vertigo. So when I stand up, usually I wake up with it and I have bouts of it. And it's really frustrating to have. And it also causes hearing loss, which I have a little in my right ear. Uh-huh. So next time you see me, I may be wearing a hearing aid. But whatever it takes, you know, it's frustrating as a singer, as an actor to be on Broadway and sort of be off kilter.
Oh, well, you have to fight that. And you do very well considering you have this Meniere's disease.
Yeah. De la soul.
De la soul. Okay, now we're going to take a break, but when we come back, I want to talk to you about being a pro-gay Christian and how much trouble that's causing
you. Okay.
We'll be right back. We're back with actress Kristen Chenoweth, who's up for an Emmy this Sunday for her performance in Glee, playing an alcoholic floozy, which is not an easy part for a Christian girl.
So, I don't know why they thought of me. I have no idea.
Are there rules against playing an alcoholic floozy girl when you're a Christian girl?
I think, you know, I've played a prostitute, an alcoholic floozy, a terrible waitress, that I am.
Uh-huh.
Lots of different characters, but, you know, I'm an actor.
You're an actor. I do. That's right. But you don't get any flack for any of that. The Christian community gets it, that it's an acting job, right?
Not always.
They don't?
Not always. I mean, what's that parent television, I'm against all the bad shows.
The Parents Television Council?
Them. They don't hate. They have a lot of hard times with Glee and, you know, the gay characters and stuff. And
I just
want to go...
What do you want to tell them? Tell them now.
I just want to say that if Jesus were alive, what would he be doing? Well... He'd probably be accepting and loving people how they're made. And I always say this, and it's really the truth. If being 4'11 was a sin, What would I do? Well, I could wear heels and I could add a wig.
You mean being short like
yeah.
you are? Yeah.
I'm 4'11". What would I do if that was a sin? I couldn't do anything about it because that's the way God made
right.
me. And I do make no mistake, I am a Christian. I believe in God, but and I don't believe he makes mistakes. So I believe that being gay is not a sin, and in fact, it's how you're made.
Well, isn't the rap that they're not committing a sin as long as they don't do anything about it?
It's like not doing anything about being short. What would I do?
Yeah.
Hide?
Yeah.
You know?
Well, but yeah, this sort of, so you're gay, but you're not supposed to have any kind of sexual behavior in your life. And yet you can't even masturbate. What are you supposed to do? Put a gun to your head? I mean, what are the alternatives to it?
You know, the thing is that I am a very spiritual person.
Yes.
But I also am, you know, I'm a sexual being. That's the way God put us together.
Yeah.
I'm not promiscuous. I think that's a different topic. If that's what they're talking about, that's a different topic.
That is a different topic. And then again, what's wrong with promiscuity?
You tell me, Joy. You tell me.
Well, I just got married, so I'm a good Christian girl, too, now.
I'm so happy that you've come to my way.
I've come to your way. Well, I am, you know, I grew up Catholic. Did you know that?
I did know that
yes.
about you. And, you know,
I was confirmed. I've been baptized, the whole nine yards. You know, I was smacked around by a nun. I've done it all.
That had to hurt, man.
Yeah. But now you grew up in Oklahoma's Bible Belt, mm-hmm. which is really interesting. But what would your grandmother, there's a story I heard that, what would your grandmother say when you would ask her, why does the Bible hate gays? What would she tell you?
Well, I would say to her, like my best friend, Denny, why? How can he be going to hell? Like, how is that possible? He's a great guy.
Yeah, your friend.
He too is a Christian, and how can that be? And she said, I just eat the Bible I read the Bible like I eat fish. I take the meat that serves me well, but I don't choke on a bone. Now,
what the hell does that mean?
It's Meniere's de la Soul. No. I take the meat that serves me well,
yeah.
but I don't choke on a bone. In other words, take what you can and learn
from the Bible.
Yeah. But you know, also the Old Testament, a lot of things were like, hey, stone your neighbor if you looked at him with a cross eye. I mean,
exactly.
you can't go there. And I know a lot of Christian people would be listening to me right now and have a problem with what I'm saying, and that's okay too. I don't judge them for what they believe. So I don't want to be judged for what
right.
I believe.
I mean, they don't believe every single thing in the Bible. I mean, Noah and all those animals on the boat, I don't think so.
Do you think Moses literally went, hey, cockroaches, come on. Oh, and snakes, you come too. I've always thought, why did he bring, you know, coyotes? Think about this.
Yeah, yeah. Why did God make...
Why did Moses say, hey, cockroaches, hey?
I didn't know Moses said that.
He invited all the...
You mean Noah. Oh, Noah.
Wow, I need some sleep.
Yeah.
Yeah, I need some sleep.
I'm wondering, why would Moses have roaches at Mount Sinai, wherever he was? Those are usually restricted to Manhattan. But you're talking about Noah now.
I'm talking about
Did Noah have roaches on the boat, too?
Well, but that's what I'm saying. I mean, you really think he invited all the
yeah.
animals? Thank you. That's my point.
Yeah. I know. And who did the pooper scooping? That's what I want to know about that
story. You know those wives did it.
The wives, Noah's wives, yeah, probably. All right, now what do you say?
So what? Who cares?
Well, somewhat. Who cares? It's right. What about these politicians who use Christianity to make their point? That bothers me.
You know, there is a
or
reason.
Any religion.
I agree.
Yeah, it doesn't
I
have to be just Christianity. I mean, you could talk about these terrorists who use Islam to kill 3,000 people on 9/11. It's the same syndrome.
I just feel like there is a reason that there should be separate. I heard my whole life, separation of church and state.
Right. There's a lot of mixing of that right now going on,
I think. It's a little frightening.
It is
me.
A little frightening. And, you know, you've done some anti-gay bullying for some PSAs mm-hmm. on that, mm-hmm. which I think is very good. Do you think that gay kids are bullied more than straight kids as a rule, or is it just
I know for a fact. I mean, I love where I'm from. I just want everyone to know that I think it's one of the best states in the union, and there's the best people in
which
Oklahoma.
Which state is that?
Oklahoma.
Oklahoma, yeah.
But bullying is everywhere. And I grew up seeing kids get bullied and my friends get bullied for being different, aka gay or whatever it was. But
uh-huh.
yeah, a lot of kids are bullied because of their sexuality, and that breaks my heart because they're gonna have to, high school's hard enough to overcome. Middle school's hard enough to overcome when we get out of it.
Yeah.
They say life is what you spend your time getting over because of high school. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I just want everyone to understand that when you're a kid and you're out there with, you know, your other peers, how important, how anytime you tease someone or say something negative, how that can go to a kid's heart. And they can take it beyond anyone. I mean, I'm pretty tough skin, but some people don't.
Yeah,
and
that's right.
It kills me that a child would take their life because of their sexuality.
Well, that just happened. I was reading about a whole slew of kids who just committed suicide in Minnesota.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm not saying that she had anything to do with it. It happens to be Michelle Bachmann's district. Yeah.
Are you kidding?
And you know, they're very anti-gay in that community over
there.
Haven't
we learned anything though, Joy?
I don't know. I mean, the Christian groups over there, the conservative Christian groups, say it's not okay to be gay. So if you're not okay to be gay, there's something wrong. I mean, I was bullied, but for different reasons.
Yes.
I was nerdy, I realize now. Mm-hmm. I didn't even know it at the time.
Right.
But you don't really feel that bad about yourself as somebody saying it's not okay to be something that you know you are.
That you are, and
yeah.
That's what kills me.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, it doesn't matter. Like you said, whatever faith you are, we have these rules of how you have to be. And if you're born a certain way,
I know.
It is the truth.
But what about the Chaz Bono now? He's on Dancing with the mm-hmm. Stars. And I understand he's getting all this hate mail and all this. People are furious that he's. And this guy, Keith Ablo, who's a shrink, mm-hmm. was on Fox. I was reading this. And he was saying that the children who are watch a transgender dance, that they're going to think that they could be transgenders. That is quite a leap.
Okay, first of all, why are we still having the conversation? That would be a can you imagine feeling like you're born in the wrong body?
That could be very, I know that's got to be
that's
very
that's got to be hard in and of itself. Why do we have to persecute and talk badly about? Why can't we just say, okay, this is a person, a man now that has changed into what he feels like he was supposed to be.
Uh-huh.
I can't imagine how hard that is on his family, on him alone.
Right.
Why then we all have to judge it? And he shouldn't be on Dancing with the Stars and that's going to affect my niece or nephew or my neighbor. No, it's not.
Leave
kids are way more accepting than adults.
So let's just see if he can dip a girl.
You know what? If he doesn't drop anybody on his head, then he's a hero.
There you go. But you know, now before I go, I don't have too much time. You have this new sitcom, Good Christian Bells.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about that. And
it's about a group of five women who grew up in the Bible Belt in Dallas, Texas, and it does deal with spirituality and it deals with how they deal with each other, their Christianity, their demons, their, you know, all the things that go on as human. It shows the human side of Christianity, and it does it with a lot of humor, and I'm very proud of it.
And it sounds like it's edgy.
It's very edgy.
Love that.
I love it.
Where is it going to be? Where are we going to set it?
It'll be on this fall, more than likely. It's ABC ABC show mid-season, so we're waiting on our air date, but we're in the middle of shooting right now, and I'm so excited for the world
shooting
to see
in
it.
New York?
Shooting in L.A.
Oh, in L.A.
Yeah.
Oh, well, thank you for coming
thank
on,
you for having
Kristen.
Me.
It's great to see you.
Me
You're
too.
Adorable.
Thank
we
you.
Love you here, right? They love you.
Thank you.
Kristen's new album is called Some Lessons Learned, and we'll be right back. Here it is.